Praise the Lord, everybody. Back to Matthew chapter 5, verse 48, and be you therefore perfect, even as your Father which is in heaven is perfect. So this is really like a part two, going on from the one that we did here a while back. But anyway, we want to just show in a quick way here that being perfect means more than just what they say with a vague definition of it means complete. Well, complete, what does that mean to a Christian? Is there a more concise definition? Well, I think we can find one. And we'll start in Philippians chapter 2 and verse 12, because we can find here something that actually lets us know what it's talking about to be perfect, even as the Father in heaven is perfect. That actually it is meaning that we're supposed to be like Him in moral character. And that's the meaning of the word perfect in the Greek. In Strong's word 5046, it means complete, it says, but then it actually goes on to say complete in mental and moral character. So complete is too vague, but moral character, we can find a lot of scripture that backs that up in the New Testament. And so in Philippians 2:12, Paul says this, "Wherefore, my beloved, as you have always obeyed." Well, people say that you can't always be obedient. See, because we're trying to say that to be perfect means to be perfect in doing the will of God. And we always hear that, well, nobody can do that. Well, here in Philippians, that local church back in the New Testament days, the Philippian church, when Paul wrote to them, he said, "Beloved, as you have always obeyed." So doesn't that sound different than saying that we all sin every day? Paul was saying to them that they always obeyed. See, that's what God's looking for in a people, that they would obey Him, that they would be perfect in obedience and holiness. So we see then the end of that verse says, "But now, much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling." So when Paul was with these people, he noticed that they were in obedience all the time. He said, "You have always obeyed," and not just in his presence, but even now that he was gone away from them. He understood that they were still walking in obedience, and he exhorts them to continue by saying to work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. So now, with fear and trembling, I think helps us to understand a little bit. See, if we don't have the fear of God, this won't mean anything to us, will it? We'll just be thinking like, well, I can go right on as I am. I can continue in sin. God's just going to keep right on loving me and being with me. But let's go to 2 Corinthians chapter 13 for a minute. And it says there in verse 11, "Finally, brethren, be perfect." Finally, brethren, be perfect. Well, the word perfect here actually means to fit thoroughly. In other words, something that is just right, something that is exact. So Paul tells the saints there, be perfect, be of good comfort, be of one mind, live in peace, and the God of peace and love shall be with you. So do you want God to be with you? Paul tells us here how it's possible, that if we'll be perfect. Now, I know this sounds to some people completely wrong, and that's because they've been taught completely wrong about what it means to be perfect. They've been taught that just because you're saved, when you got saved, that means that since you're in Christ, they would say, that you're always going to be perfect just because you're in Christ, and that you really don't have to do anything about it. They would say that you should, get some sins out of your life, probably. But very few are actually teaching what we see Jesus and the apostles teaching, which is to actually be perfect. As Paul said to those Philippians, that they had always obeyed. The Lord is concerned with obedience to His will. So now when Paul says to the Corinthians, be perfect, he means to actually be perfect in the will of God, to be exact in the will of God, to fit thoroughly in the will of God. And he says, if this happens, that if we will be of one mind, if we will live in peace, that the God of peace and love will be with us. You see, then God will be with us. You don't hear that kind of preaching, but that's the kind of preaching that they did in the New Testament church. If you'll do this, then God will be with you. Sounds really off, doesn't it? But just consider the source. It was Paul. Friends, it was Paul that said this, and not me. So then in Philippians 4, verse 9, back to the Philippian church there, Paul writes this, "Those things which you have both learned and received and heard and seen in me, do." Okay, he points them to himself as an example. You know, we say today, we hear preachers all the time saying nobody can be perfect, nobody can really walk in full obedience to the will of God. And yet Paul here points to his own self, you know, when he's telling them how to live. So he's not saying, well, you live this way and I won't do it. No, he's using himself as an example when he says, those things which you have both learned and received and heard, in other words, the doctrine he had given them, and seen in me, he had modeled it as their example, do. See, there's something that we must do. And if we will do that, he says, the God of peace shall be with you. Now, that's exactly what he said to the Corinthians, that if they would do the will of God, if they would be perfect, God would be with them. So what is that telling us? That if we have sin in our lives, God will withdraw from us. See, that's the point. If we have sin in our life, God will withdraw from us. Doesn't mean that we'll be lost, at least not right away, perhaps. But it does mean that God draws back from us if there's something in our lives that is offending him. See, can we grasp that? So when Jesus said, be you perfect, even as the Father which is in heaven is perfect, he's talking about having no sin in our life. And we can see that this must be possible, because here Paul's teaching that if they are not doing the will of God, if they're not perfect as concerning sin, that God won't even stay with them. Now, let that sink in for a little bit, and I'll be back presently to add some more truth to this.